In this video, I want to show you a tour of the Access 2016 screen and also give you some basic terminology for Microsoft Access. So Access is the database that comes with Microsoft Office, and it integrates with Excel and lots of other databases that are out there. And you can make some complete applications with Microsoft Access. Now, when you first go into Access, you see this window, and what we see is over on the left-hand side, we can open up the recent databases. We can open up a blank database, or there's some actually pre-made templates that you can use as well. Now, before we continue any further, I want to go over some basic terminology here so that Access kind of has some terms that are unique to it. So let's go over some things about that. So in this part, we're going to go over some good Access terminology. Now, the first term that you need to know about Access is a table. A table is going to be a collection of records, a list of data. Now, you're going to have a different table for each different list that you might have. So, for example, if we look at this screen here, we'd have a different table for our customers and a different table for our employees and a different table for our orders. So each table is a separate list of information. And you try to really keep each table to have one main purpose. So I wouldn't put my customers in with my employees. I would really make those separate tables. The table is the basic building block of your Access database, and it's a really important component. We're going to spend some time in these videos showing you how to build and how to maintain your tables. Now let's take a look at what a table will look like. A table is broken down in the fields. So a field is going to be a column of information. So let's take a look at what a table will look like. This is a sample Access table. And in this case, the customer ID would be a separate field. All right, each different column is a different field. And also the contact name would be a different field. So the fields are the columns. Even company name and contact title and address in this case would all be fields. Now the next important term is a record. A record is going to be a row of information. So if we take a look at the screen here, then each row is a different record, or maybe you would call that a transaction, but the official name for that would be called a record. And then this row down here would be a record as well. So all of the rows are records. So the table is made up of a bunch of records, and the record is made up of a bunch of fields. Now the next important term in Access is called a query. A query is it was almost like a filter that you would see in Microsoft Excel. We could see certain records based on the criteria. You can make simple queries or really complicated queries. And there's lots of types of queries in Access, and we'll have lots of videos for those. So, for example, here's a query, a really simple one. So let's say I want to see all the records whose country equals Italy. So when I run the query, you would get the list of all the records whose country equals Italy. So now we can go a lot further with that, but that would be a sample query. Now the next important term in Access is going to be called a form. A form is a data entry screen. So if we look at the screen here, you can see where the user would be able to do data entry, and we can add new records to a form, and you can really customize this to any degree and add a lot of functionality there. But basically, a form is a data entry screen in Access. On the other hand, a report might be the final version of the database. That's where we have printed records, and this is what you would give to your customers and your suppliers and your employees to represent your data. So here's a sample report. So this one is broken down. We have all of the orders broken down by customer, and each customer has a subtotal. So that's the kind of thing that we can do with a report. It's just a nicely formatted version of your data that you would give to your boss or to your employees or to your customers or your vendors to represent your data. And we can do lots of things with the reports here, including the subtotals and grand totals and many other things as well. But that's a sample report. The next important term in Access is a macro. A macro is where we can automate many tasks. So it's really about automation. Now you might have heard about the word macro in Excel, and it's kind of a similar term. But let's take a look at a sample macro here. So it would just be a series of steps, and it could have as many steps in there as you wanted to. And when you run the macro, all of those steps would perform in order. So it's a great way to automate several steps, and it could be hundreds of steps, but the macro is all about automation. Now, you don't have to be a programmer to make a macro. You'll see when we get into the macro videos, the macro part of these courses, then you'll see most of these options that you see on the screen would be pull downs, or, you know, there'll be other ways to select that information. You don't have to be a programmer to make a macro. Now, the next important part about Access would be a module. So with a module, it's going to be a collection of VBA code, or Visual Basic for Applications. And now with a module, you do have to be a programmer. So if we take a look at the screen here, this is a sample module, and this is the VBA language, or Visual Basic for Applications. And later on, this is probably the most advanced topic about Access. And later on, we'll have some videos about that as well. But modules, you do have to know a little bit about programming, especially the VBA programming language. Now, let's talk about the word database. A database is just a collection of information in general, and we can use the word database in that way here in Access. But also, a database is a file that contains all of the other objects. So notice, here's a database, and it has, if you look on the left-hand side, it has the tables, queries, forms, reports, and macros all in one big file, and we call that file a database. So the database really can use in two ways. A collection of data is a database, but then also in Access, the file, the actual file that contains all of the other objects, is called the database also. Now, Access is what we call a relational database. So relational database means that two or more tables can be joined together based on a common field. So let's take an example here. Notice how we have the customers table and the orders table, and they're joined together by the common field customer ID. Now, the reason that you would do that is maybe we would make queries or forms or reports that would use fields from both tables based on that relationship. So it's a very powerful part about Access, and we'll go into that further in future lessons. But basically, the relational database means that two or more tables can be joined together by a common field. And because of that common field, then we can really make tables or queries or reports that would use fields from both tables, and it would keep the record straight because of the common field. So there's some great Access terminology. Now, let's go back into Access. Now, this is the first screen that you would see when you go into the Access software. So in this case, we're going to open up a database that I made previously. So we can go into a blank database, of course, and we might do that in a future video. But in this case, I'm going to go into the tables database. I'll just double click on that. Now, here's the database file. So notice over here, now let's take a tour of this screen. So up here, you have your menu bar, or these days those are called tabs. Now, if I pick on the Create tab, notice how the whole toolbar changes, right? So, of course, these days the toolbar is called the ribbon, but you can use those words interchangeably. So, where all the icons are, that's called the toolbar or the ribbon. Where it says File and Home, of course, that's called the menu or the tabs. And when I pick on the External Data tab, or any of the other tabs, notice how the whole toolbar changes with different icons, of course. Now, if you look at the very top of the window, then you have a couple icons up there. We have Save and Undo and Redo and a couple more. That's called the Quick Access Toolbar. Now, what's great about the Quick Access Toolbar is that it stays up there all the time. And what you can do is you can put your favorite icons up there so they'll always be available. So watch how easily we can place things on the Quick Access Toolbar. So for example, I'll pick on the Home menu. And actually, we use our views quite a bit, and we'll see that in future lessons. But I'm going to go ahead and right-click on the view icon, right-click, and then I'll pick on Add the Quick Access Toolbar. And now you can see how that icon is up there. So it's really that easy to put things in the Quick Access Toolbar. Now, another thing that we might need up there is maybe Sort. So I'm going to right-click on the Sort icon, and we'll say Add the Quick Access Toolbar. And now you can see how that's up there. All right, so you have your tabs, your toolbars. Now over here, this is called the navigation pane. And in the navigation pane, we can see all of our tables and queries and the other objects of our Access database. So that gives you a quick tour of your Access database.